Good morning, good life kids. I'm so glad you decided to spend your morning with us. Let's kick it off by worshiping together through song and dance.
When night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. Faith is lost and my hope exhausted. You will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up. 'Cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Says to me, whoa, now there's no stopping what you have started until it is complete. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me.
Now, let's check in with our friends over at the Moose Dairy.
It's finally here! It's time for our special Thank You Parents program.
We're all rehearsed and ready. Nothing could possibly go wrong. I guess I spoke too soon.
These are the chronicles of the Moose Dairy Masterclass and the exceptional and very, very, very gifted students who attend, and also Alex.
Ladies and gentlemen, moms and dads, we'd like to start our presentation with an original song, Why We're Thankful for Mom and Dad.
I'm thankful for my mom and dad. They teach me right from wrong. I'm thankful that they always love.
No matter what I've done,
me fed and warm at night.
They tell me I can win.
I'm sorry. I can't do this right now. My dad texted me earlier that we might be moving to another state for his job. I don't want to go. I love it here. I guess I'm just not in the mood to sing.
Wow, that's really big news. But it's not for sure, right?
It's really unprofessional to stop a show in the middle of a song.
This ain't professional. Professional means we're getting paid to jump stuff. Someday, Dash. Someday.
Hello? Has anyone ever heard the expression, the show must go on?
The show must go on what? A stage, right?
The show must go on a stage.
I'm sorry, everyone. I just don't think I can do this right now. Maybe just do the show without me. All right. I think I can do this. Music, please.
I'm thankful that we all can trust our Savior, Lord. My parents teach me every day to depend on God's word.
Thanks, Mom and Dad.
It seems that our friend was having a really hard time focusing on the show because he just found out he's moving. And he was pretty upset by it. Maybe some of you have gotten news that made you upset and felt like you couldn't go on with what you were doing. But did you see the text that made him feel better? It wasn't a text that said, "Hey, we're not moving." No, it was a text from his mom and dad that said, "Whatever happens, they'll get through it with Jesus." Their family was deciding to trust Jesus and depend on him, knowing that he cares for them and is in control. So whether that means they move or they stay, they know that they can depend on Jesus to give them the strength that they need. Today in our Bible story, we are going to learn about a family who chooses to trust Jesus even when their brother's sick. Let's check it out.
Lazarus was a friend of Jesus. Mary and Martha, his sisters, sent Jesus a message that said, "Lord, the one you love is sick." Jesus did not go to Lazarus right away. He said, "This sickness will not end in death. It will be for the glory of God." Jesus stayed where he was for 2 days. At the end of 2 days, Jesus said, "Let's go to Judea." The disciples worried. "The Jews tried to stone you. You were going there again?" Jesus told them, "Lazarus is dead. I'm glad I wasn't there so that you may believe. Let us go to him." By the time Jesus arrived, Lazarus' body had been in a tomb for 4 days. When Martha heard that Jesus was approaching, she went out and met him, but Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." Jesus answered, "Your brother will rise again. I am the resurrection and the life. Everyone who believes in me will never die. Ever. Do you believe this, Martha?" Martha replied, "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God." When Mary saw Jesus, she fell at his feet, weeping and saying to him, "Lord, if you had been there, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw Mary crying, he was moved in his spirit and also wept. The people could see how much Jesus loved this family. Jesus went to the tomb where Lazarus' body had been buried. Jesus Jesus commanded that the stone in front of the tomb be taken away. He lifted up his eyes and prayed, "Father, thank you for hearing me. May the people believe you sent me."
So in this story, we saw that Mary and Martha trusted Jesus when their brother was sick. Even though they were going through this really hard time, they still were depending on Jesus and trusting him. In the book of John, chapter 11, verse 27, which is where our story came from today, Martha was talking to Jesus. And she said, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who is coming to the world." So even though her brother was sick and she was so worried about him and sad by what was happening, she still was saying, "Yes, I believe in you. I trust you." Good life this morning. I hope that after hearing our story, that you're reminded that whatever you're going through, God loves you and he cares about you. He's a God that brings hope to our hopelessness. And with our families, we can trust him in the good times and in the bad. Let's pray together. God, I thank you that you love us. I thank you that you are trustworthy. And I pray that you would help us to trust you with everything in our life. Help us to be examples of your love to everyone around us, our friends and our family. And God, that others would come to know you and your love and that they can put their trust in you too. In your name we pray, amen. Thanks again for joining us this morning. I hope you enjoyed our time together just as much as I did. Before we close out with one last worship song, I wanted to remind you that you can find the activity sheet and coloring page that go along with today's lesson on the Good Life website.
The dark tried to hide you and steal you away. Death tried to keep you inside of the grave. The enemy fought you, he tried but he lost. You cannot be stopped. When we cried for freedom, you tore down the stop on God. There is nothing, there is nothing.
You cannot be stopped.
There's nothing that can stop on
God. You cannot be strong.
There's nothing that can
star.